from this world.
I know why they get picked on.
Why?
Because people are jealous.
I think so. That's very good, Tara. Sarah, right?
Yeah.
It's very good, Tara. I mean, it's very insightful of you, because that's what it is. The people are jealous of their intelligence. But guess what? That intelligence is what makes these lights work. It's what, you know, makes these TVs work, all this technology around us, these buildings, you know.
That iPad.
Everything. Mm-hmm. It's because of smart people. So you guys should be, each of you probably is very smart. You don't even realize it. I bet some of you have super intelligence and don't even realize
it. And not after 9 concussions.
Okay, well maybe you're an exception. But you'll always be a good bull rider, so at least we got you for that, right? But my point is, even you, I'm sure you have some gift that you don't even know about yet. And you're gonna change the world with it, buddy. You really are. And each of you is smart in your own way. But those really smart kids, those gifted and talented ones, they call them, you know. And sometimes they even get called names like nerd and stuff like this. When I was a kid, they got called that.
I've always wanted to be glasses.
You guys should want to be around those kids.
I know. I've always hanging with that. She's like the best girl. She's well behaved.
Hang out with the gifted and talented kids, because they are the ones that are going to make this world a better place. And then tell them about Jesus. If they don't know about Jesus, tell them about him. Because once they trust you, they'll listen to you. Okay? Sometimes the reason the smart kids don't trust us is we pick on them. Don't do that. Okay? God never values a person by Christian.
See, in the high school, middle school and elementary are different than the high school. Okay. They pick on people. But the high school is like more
drawn.
So they don't really pick on
the
smart people.
They don't? No. They did when I was in high school. But it's different now. Okay.
Yeah, they're like very nice to them.
It's worse than
that. That's good.
Only because they can...
These girls always pick on different kind of girls, but not boys.
Yeah, why don't boys get picked on? Yeah,
boys don't get picked on?
No. Like, Parker does a little bit, but
oh my gosh, Parker Jordan is no offense.
Maria Bittner.
Yeah.
Girls get picked on a little more because girls in general, they're tough on each other.
Girls can't work together, no.
They're tough on each other.
Mr. D picks on Maria Bittner.
He picks on me, too.
The teacher
does? He calls me Stank and Rankin.
Yeah, I think the teachers are just kidding around with you a little
Bittner.
Bit.
He just says, "Hey, Bittner."
He calls me Stank
and just
Rankin.
Jokes around with
and
her.
And I ain't got mine.
Yeah, Shiny.
He just picked on.
That's Shiny.
I told him to stop calling me Stop.
Laffy Taffy's a cool name. I like it.
He called me Stank and Rankin, though. That's not cool.
I like Laffy Taffy. You laugh. It's a compliment.
Oh, this is my last.
You're always smiling
at
him. You're Laffy Taffy.
That's why everyone calls
me. I don't smile.
You shall call her that now.
And guess what?
Shut up.
And guess what? I think you have a very nice smile and you should keep smiling. What's up?
But here's the thing about girls, like, any girls, like, besides adults, we like to, like, girls always like gossip, drama, fights, like, over, like, something.
Can you stay away from all that?
So I can, but not this girl. This girl hates me, like, ever. She wanted to fight me, she caused me all their pain.
Are you mean to her?
No!
Have you ever talked to her?
No.
She doesn't like you.
No, it's just over a boy.
That's why.
Oh! Like,
okay.
So bad.
Well, what I would suggest to you, the boy thing, I can't give you a lot of advice.
I even try to be nice to her. She still hates me. She won't even be nice back to me.
Yeah,
just keep being nice.
I can't. Yeah, that's the advice I can give you. Just keep being nice to her.
Yeah.
When she's mean to you, Taylor, the best thing is to win an enemy attack. Even though you might not want to. You probably don't want to.
No.
But you should still not want to fight with her either.
Oh, I didn't want
to fight. Since you don't want to fight with her and you like her to stop being mean to you, just be nice. Just be like,
I do.
Oh, that's what I'm worried
about. You can try to find the time.
You can even compliment her. You can go up to her and say, "Hey, you look nice there." Yeah.
No, Roy would say that to her.
Yeah, he'd be like, "Oh, I like those shoes that you got on with her." You think she'd be mad if you did that?
Yeah, she might put on my legs.
You could try it. Or just stay away from her if she's causing you a problem. But, okay, so... God never values a person by how smart he is, does he?
No.
Does God value you for your smartness?
No. You could be stupid and love him at the same time.
Does God love you if you're stupid?
Yes.
Okay. When the Lord Jesus chose his disciples, he chose what? Ordinary people, didn't he? What was Peter when he chose Simon Peter?
Fisher.
He was a fisher of men. He's well, fisher of fish. He was a fisher, and then he was going to make him a fisher
of men.
He made him. He made him a fisher of men. You know. And what was Matthew?
Well,
you know Camden? He's a tax collector, a down low, dirty tax collector. People hated tax collectors. He chose a tax collector to be one of the starters of his church. He chose a fisherman, nasty, dirty fish, you know, to be the rock of his church. Okay? He chooses ordinary people to do great things. Each of you guys are ordinary people right now. But you are extraordinary in God's eyes. And he wants to do great stuff with you. Okay? If you just trust him, he will make a great life for you. And you will do good things. Okay? Having money is another one, right? Another way the world values people is by how much money they have, what kind of clothes they have, what kind of things they have, right? If you got all the best video games and all the best, the kids want to come over to your house and play, don't they?
Advanced Warfare.
I see Camden, he knows, because he's got the best video games, so he's probably got the most friends here. Okay, my point is, people, when you have cool things, they want to be around you, don't they?
Uh-huh.
Is that a good reason to be your friend?
No.
Yeah? Another way the world values people is in that way. The world says if your family is rich, you are worth something. But if your family is poor, you're not worth anything, right? If you live in a bad, a nasty house, like a little junky house, nobody wants to come hang out at your house either. Those aren't good friends, guys. So that's Satan lying. Satan's lies. And you don't want to be around people like that. Belle, you need to be around people like Tara in your homeroom. You know, but she's a good Christian, and the two of you together as friends could go out and make a big change in that school because people want to be around. Here's Tara and Belle. They're so nice. They're so nice. Well, guess what? Before you know it, you got this big crowd of friends around you within a year or two because you guys are so nice. Two is more powerful than one. Guys, if you go to school together, join up together, man. Because, you know, when you join up with your Christian friends, you'll start gathering people around you. You guys have a big crowd of friends, and you'll be the popular ones, and you'll make the rules.
Yeah.
And the rules are going to be around what? The rules are going to be around Jesus and what he would do, right? Your rules that you make to your social people are going to be rules of love and goodness and kindness and being good to people, okay? And all those ones that are mean to people, they'll be on the outskirts. And guess what? Maybe you'll go over there and be friends with them. And maybe they'll become good. And they'll start coming to church, and they'll start letting Jesus change them. And they'll be nice to someone. And they'll have a big crowd around them. Before you know it, the whole school just loves everybody. Is that how it works, Taylor?
No.
What?
Is that how it works?
No.
What I just said.
Say no.
Say yes.
Oh, yes.
Say yes. It does work that way. When you make Jesus and his love and kindness the center of your world, people will just revolve around that. Right, Kelly?
Mm-hmm.
Just revolve around that. Another way.
Thank you.
Okay. The truth is, money does not. Listen to me. Money does not make a person happy, does it? It's fun. It's fun, right? Money's fun.
It is.
I mean, you can buy some cool stuff, you know.
Christmas gifts for everybody.
Right. Nor does money determine your worth. Okay. When the Lord Jesus was in the world, was he rich?
No.
Was Jesus rich?
No.
So why would we want to be better than Jesus? Not that we have to be poor. Because God makes some of us wealthy. And if we use it for the right reasons, money's really good, isn't it? Because what can money do? What can we do to make money
give
useful?
Give it to charity.
Give it to poor people.
Now, do you guys actually really do that?
Yeah.
Dad,
oh, yes.
I give it to...
I did.
I
did.
Good.
I did.
St. Jude.
Good.
Twice.
Mm-hmm.
Like 3 times to 4 times.
Now, listen to me, guys. I know each of you doesn't really have a lot of money probably right now in your life, other than your parents' money. Some of you might work a little bit. But guess what? And I use Belle as an example a lot, but the reason is because I know her. And this is not to brag for her. My point is, she knows that each week when she comes to church, out of her bank account, she brings some money for church and God, you know? And what's good about that is it teaches you young, say you've got $20 this week you earn. Give $2 of it to something good. If you don't give it to the church, give it to the poor man standing on the side of the road. Send it to a charity. Do something good to help someone. Stick it in the Ronald McDonald box. You know, whatever.
Yay.
The Ronald McDonald is a great charity. They do a lot of great stuff. You know? So, I mean, find out how can you help the world around you. And I'm telling you, when you take the little bit of money that you have, and you learn to do it with lots of money when you're older, but take the little bit of money you have and give a little bit of it, God will bless you so much. He's done it. Guys, you have no idea. I've given what little money I had at times, and I don't know how I survived because I might have lost a job at the time and I couldn't pay my bills. God got me through it. He found ways for money to come in because I gave what money I had before that. He took care of me when I needed it. If you give to others and help them, God will take care of you when He needs it. You will reap what you sow, the Bible says, right? You will be blessed. Now, you don't give $2 to the tithing box out there and say, ooh, I'm going to get $20 back. You know, don't do it for that reason. Do it because you know doing that will help other people, and God will bless you in return. Okay?
It's noon.
Go ahead.
It's noon.
Okay, give me a couple more minutes, and we'll be ready. So you want to stick your head out the door, so I'm going to see if the church is out or not?
I will.
Someone do it.
No, I will.
Okay.
Carol,
there you go.
She wants to be president.
I do want
to be
president.
I'm the next maybe that's your
calling.
To be a president.
Dad, I've already president in the class.
Okay.
Yeah, I can't be a president.
Oh,
Dad.
What?
Already president in the class.
Okay, here's my final comment, guys.
Let
me skip to the end here. Because I only got halfway through because I talk a lot.
I talk a lot too.
Okay.
She does.
Well, my final point I'm going to make is that Jesus, He told us in the Bible that a rich man, it's harder for a rich man to get into heaven than to take a camel and shove it through the eye of a needle.
What?
Can you take a camel and slam it through the eye of a needle?
No, which is sad.
Okay. My point is to be rich,
really?
It doesn't mean if you're wealthy you won't go to heaven. It means that if that's all your life's about, and that's all you care about is your looks and your money and your stuff and your things and your popularity, and you don't care about other people, that you're really putting yourself in danger of being someone who's not truly a Christian, and you're not really going to go to heaven. So I want you to take your lives, focus them on Jesus Christ, and love the people around you, okay? Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank You for this time with the children. We thank You for Your word here today. We ask that you take it and put it in the hearts of these kids, and You'll allow them to take it out into their schools, into their lives, and apply it to the world around them. We thank You for the gift of Your Son, Jesus Christ. In His name we pray. Amen.